just got coming up to this camp and starting to work with them just now, which is another FIG requirement on bias. So it's really good to see that progression, but it wasn't an easy process. But it seemed that every step forward we take, we lose a little bit of technique and have to go back to drills. So girls, you know, when you end up going back to drills and things like that, it's okay. It's all really, really important to make sure you're doing your flyaway drill, flyaway drill, flyaway drill, to make sure your technique is correct. And we were flyaway drill for about 3 months before, so if you first did flyaway and they weren't too bad, and Joe would come around for testing and have a bit of wood, like, oh Josh, he's dropping his shoulders or your head's out a little bit, and you go back to drills. And we'd go back and start working drills again, and work it all the way up, get double tuck, double pike. We'd be doing double pikes, not too bad. Joe would come and have a wood, but give me a bit of a heads up, Nikolai, our head coach, would also give me a little bit of help, you know, moving head, moving shoulders in the double pike. So we kind of progress up and then have to go back to our drills and get the technique right again. That time, you know, persevering on the drills, the technique has been really good, and you know, certainly for the first time this clinic has now made a full out. I prefer the full out as a dismount. It's probably the easiest kind of dismount to do. So it's just a double tuck with a tweak in the second salto. Jed's got Emma here, who's going to show some of the progressions to start with, working with Anna and as well on how the coaching sequence works for a full out dismount. Basically, you choose a full out over a full in because it helps your body rotate better, it's easier to land, and also there's not a chance of coming back on the bar as much with a full in. And then kind of like you do on four, it's more likely you're going to turn your shoulders over and pull yourself back in on the bar, as well as drop your shoulder into your first rotation as usual. So pretty much it. So the first kind of sequence we use is just obviously the flyaway. Flyaway to feet as we do in the IDP 614. Obviously then we progress up to a flyaway to back. Okay, so I'm just going to demonstrate a flyaway to back now. So we want to see the feet peaking nice and high, going through a nice full candlestick shape before the release. Again, by circulating the top leg, keeping the head and shoulders still, making sure we release the bar. The next step I would use as well after that is flyaway to back as well, but without the arms moving. So getting the arms on these, just to make the body longer. Because you know, girls, every time you shut your leg up with your arms up, it's slower to rotate. So pulling it down speeds it up. Leave your arms up and rotate through the back, it's a bit harder. Make sure we're really kicking hard under the bar. The next step we do is spot a double tuck, or just a normal double tuck, we'll get a band to show a double tuck. Method as well is pretty good because what it helps their timing for their twist to start in the second salto.
The double's a little bit weak coming off the bat, so I like to see a double that's kind of sitting up a little bit in the second set of style. That's just like Josh said, it's preparing there for the timing of the arm action for the twist. So we're not thinking about a turn, we're still reinforcing that double. But you're starting to feel a little bit of sit up into the second somersault, ready for the action later on.
Another really important thing to mention is we're going through these drills really quickly, and these progressions really quickly. But you know, when you're actually training in the gym, it could be, you know, some girls might take a couple of sessions, some girls might take a couple of weeks, others a couple of months. Okay, so each phase of this skill wouldn't be happening this quick. Oh, I didn't open it. Okay, onto arm chin. Okay, onto full in. Full out, sorry. Each sequence has to be pretty much mastered before moving on to the next. So then you don't lose any technique.
Yep.
All right, so the next one we do is a double. So I'd go double open, land on mat, jump half. Okay, I'll do lots and lots of those. So you can do that for about 2 months, so you reckon? We're probably doing double tuck, open, jump half every time on the mat. Then we move the mats out of the pit and we've got to do half out. So she did this the first time here as well, actually. So this will hopefully do. We'll see how it goes. She wants to get a head still. So double tuck. What I like to do is try and see the pit first as they're coming around the salto before they turn the shoulder. Opened up a little bit earlier with the chest. I think also, girls, it's important to remember when you're twisting, especially backwards. If you're a left twister, you don't want to move your left shoulder. Try and keep your left shoulder still and move your right shoulder. As you're moving on top of your own body, that will help lift the second salto. Also, obviously, if you're a right twister, you don't want to move your right shoulder back. You want to try and move your left shoulder forward, then you're twisting up on top of yourself. Does that make sense?
Okay.
Right, and then from there, have a go and pull out. Obviously spend a little bit more time on the half out as well. And then if it's releasing the barbell, if the shape's nice, it's just a little bit of a harder pull. An arm action a little bit over the shoulder into the chest. Again, try to twist as late as possible. The earlier you start twisting, the more likely you're going to lose yourself in the air. So you're going to be twisting pretty late. Later and later, but so you want to try. Head still in the legs. Shape. Head. Head. One, two. A little bit of a little bit of twist, but not too bad, not too bad. I think that's pretty good steps in to getting the pull out. Something else. I was going to say, it's really important that you would have heard me aligning so far ahead of that. It's always going to be, correction all the time. Little things you need to remember all the time. Nikolai, who's kind of like the head coach of our program, is always saying that you always have to be on your genes. So girls, if the coach is always on top of you, reminding you the same thing over and over, it's not a bad thing. Okay, that's really good for you, it's probably what you need. Okay, do you want to try one more, sir? Do you want to talk one more?
Yes, one more, last time.
While she's resting and we're preparing, just quickly, I just returned from the World Championships, and I'm about to turn in my debrief and my analysis. Out of 105 bar routines performed at the World Championships, there were 28 full twisting double backs. 8 of those were the full out technique. The others were full in or half in or some variation. The variation group had a 62% chance of sticking their landing. All the rest had a 0.3 deduction. Of the 8 true full out techniques, 100% stuck landings. That is why we're choosing this technique. Okay? No questions taken on that one.
All right.